He was fourth in the Commonwealth Games back in 2018 at 10,000 metres, behind one Joshua Cheptegei. Well, today he's turned the tables on his compatriot. He's turned the tables on the world, because this young man is going to be world champion. Fabulous running at a canter with great finishing speed. Jacob Kiglimo becomes world half marathon champion, unofficially in 58.48 there. Kandie takes a super silver for Kenya.
Jacob is still young. Let us just play for him.
We still have hopes in him. We know in the Olympics he's going to make us so grateful.
If it was me, I could have just opened and then I go one way.
I was very sure today that our brother Jacob was going to win.
Valencia half marathon, Trinidad Alonso EDP. The pacemaker, Timothy Kibet. And it's Kiplimo in the orange vest on the right hand side of your screen. The world champion, Ronats Kipruto, in the blue, the light blue vest on the left hand side of your screen. Matiso has a best of 59.09. Good quality runner without a doubt. Well, 2018, when Jamal Yima set the course record, that was 41.30. But it's Kandie. Look at that steely expression on his face. Kandie now once again surging and pushing and testing. Looking around. That's going to be a battle between Kibiwot Kandie in the black vest and the orange vests of the world champion, Jacob Kiplimo. Ronats Kipruto having a fantastic debut but getting detached here. A bit further down the road is Alexander Matiso. Between these two men now as we enter the final kilometer. Kiplimo darting across the road. He's not quite sure what he's doing there. Well, we saw the 20 kilometer marker, which was passed in about 54.45. So they're about 15 seconds inside world record pace here, and they're in for some serious money as well. World record bonus. Under 58 minutes is €100,000 in addition to the first prize of €35,000. Here's the two leaders, and this is going to be a battle for not just supremacy at this race, but the world record and a very, very big check indeed. Kibiwot Kandie now surging once again, pushing hard. Jacob Kiplimo tracking his every move. What are these two men? They battled for victory at the World Half Marathon Championship 7 weeks ago. On that occasion, it was Kiplimo who triumphed. Kandie, second on that occasion. At the moment, now surging again. Long, long way down the road. It's Ronas Kipruto having an absolutely terrific debut, but he's back in third. But it's looking as though Candy has a change of gear. He's pulling away now from Kiplimo. This is absolutely going to smash the world record out of sight. That world record from Copenhagen 2019 by Jeffrey Kamworor. Just keep your eye on the clock, 58.01. And Kibiwot Candy now coming into the finish line. Kiplimo's got nothing left. 100 meters to go. It is going to be a world record. You can see it on the tape. Kibiwot Candy, unofficially 57.32. A world record for the Kenyan, taking a stunning 29 seconds off the world record. Absolutely magnificent.
And I'm so happy to see that Kiplimo has made a run of 27. As Ugandans, as for us Ugandans, we are very happy for him for being the first Ugandan to run 27. And then I see Uganda is going to make a record. If possible, we come, if Kiplimo will come back and then we work together, I see everything will be okay. Let us pray for the next. But Uganda, we are doing well. Everyone, let. Don't worry, we are going to make it as Ugandan, as again. As for us here in Kapchoro here, we are going to train together, we work hard so that we see.
You have to be very technical, you have to have technology, techniques and technology. You are, when you have the planning, you can win. If not like today, Kande. Because Kande, the other time, Kande, Thiago Kiplimo beat Gandhi that time. So Gandhi never sleep. I think the man trained seriously because they know the man.
What mistake I think Kiplimo made today, he was in front early enough. He did not time well. You know, being a champion, everyone's time you because he won the other time World Half Marathon, but now they were timing him. Even Gandhi was prepared for him. That's why Gandhi won.
Not quite sure what he's doing there. Well, we saw the 20 kilometer marker, which was passed in about 54:45.
It's only that if you could target him well, like if you watch the last kilometer, it was 1k. It reached at the middle of 1 kilometer. Actually, he was trying to test whether he can escape, but not knowing that the guy still have some energy to go, you understand?
If it was me, I could have just open and then I go one way because but I doesn't blame him, it was a tough race.
When Jacob was racing, I was busy in charge.
We just want to thank you, Mom. We just want to thank you.
My concentration most was I had to go and serve God, and then I allow God to do his part by making him run well. So when I was in church, that's when I received some messages which were saying congratulations. But when I checked the results, I saw that Jacob was number two. So a little bit I was like, wow, what has happened? But when I look at the time, then I say also Jacob did it great. He did it very well. I was very sure today that our brother Jacob was going to win, though the results changed. But above it all, I say that he did it very well. He is now the one who is having the current national record even in Uganda. So he performed super, because nobody here has run 57.
should give God an honor for his habits, prayer.
The message I can deliver for him is he should come back and work hard like the way Candy has worked, because Candy has just been targeting him. Remember the London Half Marathon? Oh yeah, he won this guy. Actually, that one taught a lesson for Candy. That's why he went back and trained with his name. But we are hopeful that he's going to also disappoint him like the way he has done for him today. But he did well.
I remember during World Half Marathon, Candy was second, but he went back and revenge, and he went back and trained, and he thinks where he loses the other time. That's why he was able to win and break the world record. Even Kiplimo, by next year, I hope the record will be in Uganda.
2018, as I said, with eighth place, and Joshua Cheptegei, the man of the moment, the world record holder at 5,000 and 10,000 on the track, and Jacob Kiplimo, only 19 years old, fastest man over the 5,000 in this year, bar Cheptegei, and the quickest over 3,000 metres, a former world junior cross-country champion. Seb Coe is the starter, the World Athletics president. Vonders in the white vest of Switzerland, pushing on hard. Cheptegei will be cruising at whatever tempo is laid down, certainly through the first half.
The East Africans, Stephen Makoka of South Africa at the back of that group. Several Moroccans still, Morocco currently in fifth place at 10K.
They're coming up towards three-quarter distance, and I just feel as though they've left it too late. Cheptegei, mind you, back in what, about eighth place? Yeah, eighth place there, probably 15 metres off the front 10, striding along and looking relaxed. Well, Kiplimo looking very comfortable, young Jacob Kiplimo. He, like Cheptegei, good on all surfaces. He won the World Junior Cross Country back in 2017. Cheptegei has suffered his own moments of utter disaster. Kiplimo looking very comfortable, lovely looking runner, isn't he? Great balance. This is the man who in his fourth race of 2020, is looking for a fourth victory, is beginning to crank it up. Kanye struggling to go with him, but it is single file now with about 4 kilometers to go. But Kiplimo must be growing in confidence.
Yeah, I mean, Kiplimo finished a close second to Cheptegei in the World Cross last year, and I was surprised that Cheptegei allowed such a big gap to develop.
Here is Joshua Cheptegei. Many expected him to cruise to victory here. His 5,000 world record represented 3 times a mile in 4:03. But maybe that is the key to what we're seeing unfolding here, which is a bit of a shock that he isn't looking like he's going to win this one. To be fair to him, he was told that the half marathon originally was back in March, and he trained hard for that one. And then he trained for the track when it was delayed until today. Well, he is going to run quick. It's definitely going to be under 60 minutes, but how far under 60 minutes? Look how beautifully he moves. That stride, the bounce, the fluidity. That is poetry in motion from Jacob Kiplimo. He was fourth in the Commonwealth Games back in 2018 at 10,000 metres, behind one Joshua Cheptegei. Well, today he's turned the tables on his compatriot. He's turned the tables on the world, because this young man is going to be world champion. Fabulous running at a canter with great finishing speed. Jacob Kiplimo becomes world half marathon champion, unofficially in 58:48 there. Kandie takes a super silver for Kenya. He did so much of the hard work in the latter stages to break up the pack after a faltering, slow, nervous first half by that big group.
The reason Jacob Kiplimo is special is when you look at his family, you find that family, Jacob comes from a family where almost everybody is an athlete. So it is a kind of a gene that he inherited from his father. You see, his father was once an athlete. Now, when you look at his brothers, Chemonges is running, Chemonges Robert. When you see his brother, Jelimo Oscar, is running. When you see also his brother, Kiplangat Victor, is also running. And then also Jacob had a brother called Chelangat Peter, like my name. He used to run, but later he came out of running. So you realize that there is something special in their family lineage. Then coupled to that, when you look at the life of Jacob, he's somebody who is very disciplined as an athlete. he disciplined himself in a way that he trains very hard, and then he disciplines himself. You find him that he also attends church, he goes for church service, he knows that he has to train very well, and then he believes that he has to live a good life, he has to eat good, and then also to serve God. Now, when you look at all those things, those characteristics, it makes him a very special athlete among other athletes. So it puts him at a special position.
You know, Kiplima those days, she was having the brother, big brother. Then big brother, it was running with those of Moses Kipsiro. That's why the man, during those those days, she always training with that that brother.
The big brother.
Yeah. And it was like three of them, but different mommy. Yeah. And those boys started just like that. Until they have made people to to come.
Kiplimo is stronger of the two.
Kiplimo, this is his second marathon. Only one Ugandan in the race in Valencia. We had six Kenyans. Ah! One against six. This guy went there to perform. But me, I hope with time, Kiplimo is going to break that record. Kiplimo tried. Still young. And Kandie, they are going. It's my age, almost my age. I like this saying of Kipchoge, no human is limited. Another motivating factor was about Joshua in cross country, in our own land. People say it, he was running backward, But after, miracles happen. Even Kiplimo, I have confidence.
Ronax Kipkoskai, Alexander Mutiso at the front, Jacob Kiplimo, and also in there, Philemon Kiplimo and Kelvin Kipton.
That was not his time, but Jacob is still young. Let us just pray for him. We hope he's going to make it more coming years.
And it's going to be a battle between Kibiwot Kandy in the black vest and the orange vest of the world champion, Jacob Kiplimo.
The same Kandy, Kibiwot, the guy we beat in Poland again. So I'm seeing a scenario where Kandy comes, Jacob comes, and then Kandy comes. So we believe that the next race, we shall again be number one.
It's between these two men now as we enter the final kilometer.
We still have hopes in him. We know in the Olympics he's going to make us so grateful.
That is poetry in motion from Jacob Kiplimo.
Uganda is having a very good period now with Joshua, Halima, Jacob Kiplimo. We have to all, I'm also making some worries.
Why?
Because below them, on this moment, there are not a lot of big talents coming.
The Olympics is going to be bloody. That's the term I normally use. Not the usual blood, but it's going to be bloody. You know, climbing up, going to be number one in the world is easy, but how to maintain it? As a nation, let us not be excited. Because of Joshua, because of Kiplimo, because of Nanyondo, Nakai, and these others. No? This is a time all of us, from all the clubs, the national level, all the stakeholders of sports, to start to invest. Let us invest. No investment to the athletes, no medal. Everybody is now very happy for our colleagues, Cheptegei, Kiplimo, and many others. But we need to give them morale, financial, moral, emotional, everything, social, because the world is watching us. They're not sleeping. You saw yesterday, Kiplimo, the guy who was number two, gave him a good challenge. So meaning that the world is not sleeping. The nation must not sleep. All of us must not sleep. We must invest in the young men. Yeah? The chances of our two guys to perform is high. I motivated myself. But the others who are behind, whom we are not seeing, that can perform better than them.
Sprinting for home now. Kiplimo answers. What a race we've got on our hands.
What I know in the preparation, it takes only hard work, discipline, and focus from the athlete first. So the coach should be working in line to the aspirations of the athlete. So if the athlete is actually having a different mind and you are really pushing the athlete to do, it is a little bit quite technical that you cannot achieve at that level. But if you are pushing it for the dream that an athlete has like Joshua, because Joshua is one of those dedicated athletes and very disciplined, like Jacob Kiplima as well. You are inspired to really push to ensure that you do the best for them in training. Also them, they ensure they are doing the best. That makes it easy for them to really win in a big championships.
Not that we are only focused on the top level, but because then, yeah, there is a chance, and we had it in the past, that after the Kip Ciro's and the Kipro teachers, that there is nobody. Yeah. So we need also to think already about the future after Nakai, Kiplimo and Cheptegei.
Yeah. We used to have the normal competitions of 5,000, 10,000, but unlike these days, they have changed a little bit. So it becomes difficult for us to see because there is kids athletics. You know, in kids athletics, you go, you jump on something, you run, you roll, something like that. So it becomes a little bit. But where I normally attend so much in the region is almost all the secondary schools competitions in Kapchorwa, Queen and Bukwa. I attend those ones so that it is easier for me to identify those upcoming athletes. So when I identify two or three, I invited them to be joining us in the camp, or we lobby for them for scholarships in some schools within the region, and we keep on following them until when the time comes, they will be part of the team in police. So that's how we have actually succeeded also in identifying some of these good athletes. As a country for the Olympic Games, we are really, really looking for the best, like us Uganda. We had launched here sometimes before the COVID thing came in, before the postponement. The Japan from the Olympic Village from that side had extended that hand to Kapchorwa because they had identified that the Kapchorwa was going to be one of those towns or cities, we call it now a city of champions, a home of champions here. That identified that we are going to maybe possibly we have a gold here already. Yeah. That we are looking into that. So as a country, we expect the best this time. We are not only seeing it like one medal this time round, but we are looking into a little bit more of from one to almost five medals. Wow. From athletics. That's where we are really working into and looking into for those championships, this Olympic game.
I have got the expectation that in the next year's Olympics, Jacob will perform very well. I know when the two of them, you put Jacob together with our senior brother, Joshua Cheptegei, when you put both of them together, they will do great for this country, Uganda. And I really appreciate the kind of teamwork that they both have. Like when you look at today, when I just saw the results, I realized that one of the challenges that our brother maybe could have gotten is he was running as an individual, as the only Ugandan, against a team of soldiers from Kenya. Like when you look at the Kenyans, were many. So they must have teamed up against this man. So at the end of the day, the Kenyans had to take. So it is a challenge to us also maybe that next time we should be having like two or three so that they can run as a team, they coordinate together so that they can perform better. But Jacob did it very well. Yeah. I mean, it's all that. He did it very well.